Good day everyone. So now we'll discuss about how to program the digital to analog converter of ARM7 processor. So to understand about this digital to analog converter, we need to see the register structure of DAC and its generic functionality. So these are the features of your digital to analog converter. It is a 10-bit digital to analog converter and it follows this resistor string architecture, and it can have this buffered output, and you can make it to go into power down mode, and it can select the speed versus power. So in whatever the speed and whatever the power consumption is required, that you can select. So here this 10-bit digital to analog converter signify that your maximum value will be 3FF, because like for 8-bit it is FF. So with 8-bit on the left hand side, you'll be adding two more bits to get 10-bit. So in that 8421 series, you'll get on the left hand side, you'll get two bits. That will consist of 3. So you will have 3FF. Then the pin description has been specified over here. You have this A-out, this is connected to port pin P0.25, and its analog value will depend upon the digital value that you have put in DACR register. So the value will be value divided by 1024 into VREF. VREF is the reference voltage wherein you can feed in what is the reference voltage that you require at the output, the maximum voltage. So VREF will give you an idea of what is the maximum value and what is the resolution and what is the step size. Step size in the sense of what will be the voltage that will be coming out if a minimum digital value has been put in the DACR register. So here this 1024 signify the 10-bit data, 10-bit hexadecimal. 3FF equivalent will be 1023, and 1023 plus, I mean, the 0th position taken into consideration, it becomes like 1024. So to find a value of the output, you need to do this calculation, the value divided by 1024 into the VREF. And this V reference will signify the maximum amplitude. So coming to this DACR register, so it looks like this. So in which your 0th bit to 5th bit is reserved, while 6th to 15th is the position where you'll have to put the value into, and the 16th bit is for setting the bias. So bias is like if you want 1 microsecond settling time and 700 microamps of current, maximum current, then you'll put 0, or else if you want 2.5 microseconds as settling time and the maximum current as 350 microamps, you'll put it as 1 in the bias. And the 17th to 31st bit is reserved again. So here this is the position where you'll have to put the values into, so that we'll have to keep it in mind while programming the DAC. Okay, so this is concerned with the DAC. Now getting into this pin cell register, because as far as this DAC is concerned, we need to activate the pin cell. So here in this case, you can see the pin cell registers are given with different functionalities. In the pin cell 0, you can see 0th bit and the 1st bit of pin cell 0 is connected with port 0.0. So this is 0 and 1st bit. If it is 00, it is GPIO port. If it is 01, serial communication, it will be used as a for transmitting. And if it is 10, PWM1, and 11, it is reserved. So correspondingly, each and every port pin is having 2 bits associated in the pin cell 0 register. So pin cell 0 register totally will have the control over 16 pins of port 0 register, sorry, port 0 pins. So you can see over here. So in the previous program, the port programming, we didn't initialize the pin cell register, because by default, if you are not putting anything into the pin cell register, 00 will be the value that will prevail inside the register. So if 00 prevails, invariably all the port pins will behave as a general purpose IO. So that's the reason we haven't initialized anything in the port programming. But as far as DAC is concerned, we need to specifically initialize the pencil register to get the corresponding activity, corresponding initialization. So here, this pencil 0, you can see up to P0.15. So that is the 13th pin that is connected with 31 and 31st and 30th pin bit of pencil 0 register. So as far as this DAC program is concerned, we are not going to use pencil 0 register, but pencil 1 will be using. Here this P0.25 is the significant port pin, which is connected to 19th and 18th pin of the pencil 1 register. So wherein we need to put 19th bit as 1 and the 18th bit as 0 to activate the P0.25 as the DAC output. So this we'll have to keep it in mind while programming the DAC. So with this introduction, let us get into the programming. So this is a simple programming with DAC, like to generate a sawtooth waveform. So here, as we have done earlier, the area, then label, comma code, comma space read only. This is initializing the whole program itself. So the area that I'm assigning with the label, and I'm specifying that this is going to be a code, and whatever I'm typing over here should be saved as a read-only memory that I'm specifying. And the pencil 1 EQU is assembler directive, so I am equating E002C0004 to pencil 1, so that when I'm using this pencil 1 label inside the program, that will be replaced with this 0xE002C004. So, and DACR, this is digital to analog converter register, so wherein I'm putting 0x006C000, that is the memory address for DACR. So all this memory address you can always check with the data sheet of the processor. So from the data sheet we'll have to keep these addresses. So these addresses are very specific, you can't change this address. So if you change the address, the required functionality may not happen. So you'll have to be careful with using this addresses. So coming into the program, so LDR R3 comma equal to 0x 0000003FF. So this 3FF I have already explained, that is going to be the maximum value that that your DACR can hold. So that I'm initializing it in the R3 register. LDR R1 comma equal to pencil 1. So R1 is loaded with the memory address of pencil 1. Then LDR R2 comma equal to 0x000840s. So you can see this value is obtained by this one. You can see this is the pencil 1 register. We have already discussed the 19th and 18th pin of pencil 1 is connected to the port P0.25, wherein the 19th bit I am making it as 1 and 18th bit I am making it as 0. So all the other bits I am not concerned with, so I'll make it as 0. So only this 19th bit I am making it as 1. So this is 3 zeros, then since 19th and 18th is 1 and 0, so this brings out the value 8, and the remaining other values are 0. So this value I am moving into the pencil 1 register to make the DAC out getting activated. To make DAC activated, I am doing this operation. Then then DACR, so this 8000 is moved into the pencil 1, so by this instruction STR R2 comma within brackets R1. So R1 is having the pencil 1's address, and towards that address this value moves into, so your DAC is activated. So LDR R0 comma DACR LDR R2 comma equal to 0x0. So this R0 I'm initializing with the DACR register's address, and R2 I'm clearing it initially. So R2 I'll be using it for generating the sawtooth wave. So sawtooth wave is created in such a way that it should start from zero and gradually it has to rise to the maximum, that is 3 ff, and then when it has reached 3 ff it should fall to zero. So that is the basic logic of sawtooth. So for that I am initializing this R2, then LSL signifies logical shift left, R1 comma R2 comma #6. So this I am doing because the DAC register has this format that we have discussed earlier. You can see and the 0th to 5th bit is reserved, so you can't put anything into it. But while you do the incrementing operation or anything, everything starts from the initial bits, the LSB. So what we'll do is in the R2 register we'll do all the incrementing and other functionalities, and after that we'll be just left shifting it 6 times so that it falls in this place, the value, whatever the incremented value that we have, falls in this place. So LSL R1 comma R2 comma #6, the R2 content is taken and 6 times it is shifted left and the result is stored in R1. So STR R1 comma R0, so R1 is having the left shifted value, R0 is having the address of DACR register. So this moves into the DACR register. Then I am incrementing R2 by 1 by this instruction, add R2 comma R2 comma #1. So R2 is incremented by 1. Then I am comparing this R2 with the content of R3. So R3 is the maximum 3 ff. When 3 ff is reached, it will come out of the loop, or otherwise it will increment and it will left shift 6 times, then put the value into the DACR register, again increment, so it will go on. So compare R2 comma R3, I am using BLT. BLT signifies branch if less than. So D2A is a label, so I can put anything over here, it's not mandatory, you'll have to use only D2A. So D2A you can write, or L or loop, whatever you want you can write. So D2A, so branch if less than, which is less than R2, when it is less than R3 this will be branching. So when R2 becomes equal to R3, so it will come out of this loop and it will put R2 with a value of 0x0, then branch D2A again. So this will happen in a closed loop. So after R2 is initialized to 0, again it comes to D2A, so that again the process of putting the value of the content of R1 into DACR after it has got shifted using this LSL will happen. LSL is logical shift left, will happen again and again, so until we stop the program. So now we'll just try to simulate it. So to check it, we'll have to click this view analysis window, logic analyzer. If it goes on like this, you just click here and drag it out and then make the window bigger so that you can see what it is going on, and click setup. In the setup, click this new insert button and type AOUT, out, then close. Now you run this button, you can see now the sawtooth waveform is appearing, and you can always click this D bar A converter to look what is happening. So you can see this is a DACR register, whatever things that we are putting over here is obtained as such, and the value is shown over here, and the VREF is fixed as 3.3. In case if you want you can change, I am changing it to 1.3 and let us see what happens. So you can see that the amplitude has changed and the resolution also will be changed. So I'll make it to the original position again, so you can see the amplitude is getting changed. So this is the sawtooth waveform generation using the DACR. Then now we can check triangular waveform. So sawtooth we can close and we'll remove, and I'll add this triangular waveform. waveform is added. So triangular waveform, it's not a big deal. So you can see on the same three instructions has been written as in the previous case. So area, this declaration, and pincel 1 I am declaring with the memory address, and DACR with the memory address. So LDR R3, so you can see from here to here almost it is the same as the sawtooth waveform, wherein R3 I am moving the maximum value that your DACR can hold, and R1 is having pincel 1 register's memory address, and R2 is having the 0x000840s. So this is to activate the DACR register, that I am moving it into R1 to initialize the pincel 1. Then DACR I am addresses I am putting inside your R0, and R2 I am clearing. Then D2, I am having two loops in this case. One is D2AP and another one is D2AN. So D2AP is like it is going from 0 to the maximum, while D2AN will be maximum to coming returning back to 0 again. So here LSL R1, R2, #6, this you know what it is for. R2 content is logically left shifted 6 times, and the result is placed inside the R1, and the R1 content is stored inside DACR register, that is the address is available in R0. Then I am adding, so incrementing happens over here, add R2, R2, #1. Then I am comparing the R2 content with R3. R3 is the maximum 3FF. So BLT is branch if less than. When R2 is less than R3, this will be branching to D2AP, and it will be executing the same function again and again. And when R2 becomes R3, and when R2 becomes equivalent to R3, so it comes out of this loop, and LSL R1, R2, #6 happens, and it gets into the negative loop, and STR R1, within brackets R0, so happens, and here the decrementing happens, SUB, you know, subtract, and SUBS subtract and affect the flag registers R2, R2, #1, and instead of putting the compare statement, since I made it like SUBS, I'm just checking the zero flag by putting this BNE. When if zero flag is not set, again I am jumping over here, and I'll be repeating the process again and again, and when R2 has reached to zero, I'll be jumping to D2AP, and from zero again it will go to maximum. So the process repeats again and again, so until you press the stop button. So let us check the output for this case. So you can see the triangular waveform is generated, and in the same case as we have done earlier, you can go for changing the value, it will get changed 3.3. okay, so this is triangular wave. So now the triangular wave or sawtooth wave, we have done this simulation. If you want to dump the same into the processor board, then certain instruction is essential. So that instruction is will be you'll have to click this options for target, or you can click this project options. So again, I mean, you can close this, and again you can click options for target. So you'll get like this, a window like this. Click the output and click this create hex file. So your name of the executable file that will be created is WE. You can search the path where it is getting stored by this particular button, select folder for objects. So here only your WE.hex file will be saved. So this WE.hex is the file that you will be dumping into your processor board. So it is in program and objects. Okay, so after clicking this, again we'll have to click this translate, build and rebuild. So in case if you want to check again, you can go and check whether the WE.hex is created. So here you can see WE.hex is created, and this hex file you'll have to dump into the processor board. So after you have dumped the hex file into the processor board, then you should take the output. So for taking the output, you need to understand about the blue board schematics. So to know about the blue board schematics, we'll look into this particular sheet. So this is the blue board schematics of NGX board that we are going to use. So in which we are concerned about this port P0.25. We have to look into where is this P0.25. So you can see P0.25 is available over here, and that is connected with P0_825. So this P0825, we need to see it in this junctions J1, J2, J3 and J4. So these J1, J2, J3 and J4 is available as access points in your ARM processor board. So here P0_825 is available in the 9th pin and 6th pin. You can take it as a ground. So while you are after you have dumped the code into the processor board, you will be connecting the positive end of the probe, the CRO probe, to the 9th pin, and the negative end of the CRO probe to the 6th pin of J1 of the ARM 7 processor. So this is the explanation. So let us go for dumping the code into the processor board. So in the Flash Magic, you can see these are the settings that you'll have to keep, and in addition to that, the options you select for advanced options, and you'll have to check this use DTR and RTS to control RST and ISP pin, and keep RTS asserted while COM port open, and T1 and T2 should be 100 and 200 milliseconds respectively. Then timeouts, you just see to that this is checked. Use my timeouts for ISP operation. These two things has to be taken care of. Then after that, you click on browse and click the X file that has been created, and click open. Then you go for connecting your RS232 towards your processor board. Then you click the start button. So now it is getting programmed. So the status bar has come to the maximum. After it has come to the maximum, you will remove this RS232. After removing the RS232, then you connect your probes positive end to 9th pin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and negative to 6th pin, that is ground. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now you can see the triangular, sorry, sawtooth waveform that has been obtained. Okay, close. So now the triangular waveform program has been typed, and for which the target option in the output create hex file has been checked. So the hex file will be created with the name of gh.x, and that gh.x will be going for dumping into the processor board. So translate, build and rebuild. Now the gh.hex file has been created. Now again in the Flash Magic, click advanced options, check these two things, and timeout, and click this browse gh.x open, then connect your RS232 and click start. So the program has been dumped, and I'll remove the RS232. As I have done earlier, I'll be connecting the positive to the 9th pin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and the negative to the 6th pin, that is ground. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6,
and you can see the triangular wave that has been generated. Okay.